Clyde and Hank are going to try to put the crash bars on the Rebel 1100 DCT. So let's see how they do. Hang in there. Should be interesting. All right. This was the right side. Clyde told me that that's correct, that this is the right side. This and this will have to come off for this side. And then on the other side, correct?
Yeah.
This and this?
This thing's got to come off.
Okay. Oh, wait a minute. And this thing? B. All right. This is the left side, and we have to take this off here and the horn up there, right there. We got to take that horn off. Other than that, we'll see what we can screw up.
We just want to have room to where we don't lose anything. Okay. That's one.
Now, does that whole piece has to come up? Just, we can't just pull that little piece out, huh?
Well, we need this piece off, which is part of this whole thing,
okay,
in order to get to that. So, right. I'm saying, they say it's got to come off. And it looks like it's got to come off. At least they didn't put it on with a
torque wrench that we can't get it off. 100-foot-pound
torque wrench. Well, I should shut my mouth. Oh, beautiful. Okay. So these are just kind of snugged up. No.
Now, if I remember in the video, you have to kind of play with it a little bit. Well, like it tilts up or something. Oh, wait, you got another one here, right?
Nope.
Oh, that's not.
I don't think so.
Okay.
Good. Maybe it is, but I don't. Oh, wait a minute. So we still have something holding it on.
Yeah. This one here is holding it on?
No, they're right here, right there.
Yeah.
Okay. So it was 4 bolts, and that's what they said. So I think we're on track. If you want to grab that.
They said, there we go. It has to kind of go in at an angle.
Okay, and then these go with that.
This side here, we have to take the horn off. Oh, it's got a bolt. I see what you're taking it off on.
Well, because I think this bracket is going to get replaced.
Yeah, you're right.
So you might as well take it off, and we'll replace this bracket. Lator. So if you want to put this
up here with this
up
one,
up there with that one,
yep.
And hopefully we'll get some extra. Hopefully we'll get enough wire to be able to move it, unless it's going to hang sort of down.
Make sure that you have a support under the engine before you take that bolt out. Here, that bolt has to go through to the other side. Yep, it's coming.
So what is going to drop here? There we go.
Keep coming. You got it out quite a ways. There we go.
Whoa, are you out?
Well, I'm out enough that we haven't dropped the spacer on this side yet.
Okay, so we need... This one is kind of tight, so I don't know what's going to happen when I let go of it.
Try to get the bike as level as possible. We didn't have a jack, so we had to use the wood to support the engine. What do you mean?
Could you come around and stand to hold the handlebars and make sure that this doesn't get wild and crazy on us?
Which way you want me to go, that way?
Yeah, don't. I'm just not sure what's going to happen when this thing pops out.
Another piece of wood.
Okay, almost.
Okay.
Okay, so he's out. Put him there.
Oh, you got it that far?
I got it to where it started. So I guess if you want to pound. But of course, there's no telling. Let me get a flashlight. Bolt is low.
Can you see it?
This has to come down.
Probably should have taken that side cover off. Made it a lot easier to get what we wanted done.
Oh, don't nut out. That's not gonna work.
Hit it back towards you. There you go, one more. Okay. Now it can go up. I don't know, on your flashlight if you can see.
Whew, I can see it, but...
Is the bolt's not through yet, right? So the bolt's not stopping you. Okay.
That's a little closer. Where is it, baby?
Keep coming. Keep coming. You're not there yet.
To the...
You're not out on the... Oh.
Shit.
See, this thing's got to come up.
Oh, yeah. I know. I see it. Yeah. Okay, so how do we do that? Oh. Not moving.
Huh.
You're holding it up?
Yeah.
Try laying it back, you know, resting it again. We didn't move, so stand it up again.
Okay. We learn as we go. Take the foot peg and horn off first.
Shiny black here. Shiny black here. That way we know where that goes. Okay, beautiful. See where we're at. We're gonna take this out, right?
Yep, take them right off. And that'll give you the room that you need there.
Do we have to replace these bolts with those longer ones, or?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Lift it out. Yep, there we go. Okay. So if you want to just start those, and then we'll see what we can do on the front. I'm gonna try to come back down your way so I can come over to that side to hold it, so watch yourself.
Oh, yeah, hold it.
That should sit there.
Okay.
Now I'll come over to this side.
Switch.
So now, is it lining up? I don't know, Clyde.
I gotta look at it. We might have to, you know, heat and beat a little bit, but.
I like the looks of them.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Mucho closer.
Okay. Let me hold this. Got one side on.
And we don't have to worry about the motor dropping out.
No. It's already fallen 4 feet, but that's okay.
I think that's fine.
Okay, so you want the nut to go on that? But not tighten
it? Are we through with it?
Well, with the front part, yeah.
I'd say let's definitely put it on and
okay.
Not snug it yet, but.
And then what we'll do is we'll take out those bolts and put that foot lever on. I think the hard part's
I stopped.
You've seen that big socket
right here. Oops, it's under the paper.
Ah, that's exactly the one.
Okay, we got it started.
I will let you know. Oh, definitely. It's snug, hand snug. Wish I had that. I want to start it with the wrench. Oh, I can do this.
I think you got it, by
Helen. I want to finger tight this baby. What she said. Get a finger
tight.
Shit,
we got one side on. Maybe. So that's on.
Okay, you like that?
Yeah.
I do too. So I'm taking this stuff out. Okay, so on to the other side, right?
Yeah, watch yourself.
It'd be nice if it just lined up and went in. Merry Christmas!
Okay.
I know a washer's not fitting in there, man. That was tight.
Yep.
They figure that to the nth degree.
So now all we got to do is hook that bar across and then hook up the... That's good.
Whoo! Wee doggy! Okay.
That's good.
Did you tighten all these bolts?
I couldn't.
Because my face was in the way? Yeah, oh, well, we still got a bar.
Yeah. Which is...
Do you want to do the bar or do you want to go get
a
drink?
Yeah, I'll tell you. Let's just get the bar the hell out of the way and then we'll come back and tighten the shit.
Yeah, I'm already down here.
But where's the bar?
Oh, no.
Here, I got it.
Something like that. Here, I'm going to loosen that up even more. We got to bend these in.
Okay, wait. Yeah, there we go.
In or out? Or
it's got to, wait, now I got the scoop caught.
Are you in?
I'm in.
Sweet Jesus.
It always helps to have a good friend to help you when you need it the most. This is really a two-man job, so try to get someone to help you.
Yeah, I just snug this one up if you want to snug that one up, and then we'll tighten. We'll tighten it like they do, where we just, snugs it up and not any major pressure. Like no major pressure. I don't trust their bolts and everything. Snap off. I'm through here. As long as that one feels good and taut.
And this one is too.
All right. Okay, that's...
That's it, buddy.
We kind of torqued that. Now then, how about the two on the back?
Yeah, I haven't tightened those yet.
Okay.
on either side.
So that was a big Allen. Big boy Allen.
Stop calling me Allen, that's not my name.
That's my
name. Clyde, this is where I got stuck last time.
Oh, getting up? Camera, come get him.
I'm going to do that way up. Your side, I think, is fairly tight.
You got to put another little cover over there.
Yep. Yeah, cover over. Oops.
The horn wart.
Yep.
Everything looks good there.
Yeah.
We got this big bolt tightened.
Tight. Okay, I'm tight over here.
Was there a cover or something over that, or was it?
Over
it
what?
It was just like that, wasn't it?
What?
Over this nut on the big bolt. I guess that was just it.
I don't know. I got to get up and look. I don't think so.
I think it was just like that.
There's a cover on this side.
Yeah, we got to do a cover. And then that thing on the foot peg.
Where's the table? Yes, he made it up.
Barely.
It'll go on. It has to go kind of cockeyed.
You're a little cockeyed.
I've been definitely cockeyed.
Whoa, that'll never happen again.
There you go, buddy.
Whoa.
What size are these?
Oh, those
are... The little...
Yeah, that little five. And these are just snugged in, so I just want the Allen wrench.
Here.
Beautiful.
Look at this shit.
We're close. I like it when nothing twists off or
strips
or, you know, anything like that.
So far, so good.
I like it a whole lot. Okay.
One more. Stay down.
Oh, yeah, I just got my legs were going to sleep.
I thought you were getting up on me.
Oh, no. I'm dying. My legs
were dead. I shouldn't have taken it out. You know what that actually does?
Yeah, but we didn't know. Uh-oh. I do not know. What does it keep your foot from hitting on the inside?
No, it keeps
keep your foot centered on this.
No, if you lose the counterpin.
Come on, I'm still guessing.
Okay. Let me know when you're done guessing.
This does. I don't know.
It keeps the pin in there, it can't come out. This pin here, because it hits. So you can't lose it. Even if you lose the cotter pin and everything.
I'll buy
else.
That for a dollar.
Yeah, let's see.
I still think it keeps your foot kind of centered on here.
It might too. But
yeah, let's go with that. That's
how about it's got two functions?
Let's go with two functions.
Okay. All right, folks.
Since it is a crash guard.
So that's this side with the horn. Now, it is a little harder than you think as far as it is a two-man job.
I think so, too.
It's almost, this is almost 2 hours of videoing.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you just leave the...
Cameras running.
Cameras running like I do at your studio?
There we go. Job well done.
Crash bars by GV. We got them on. I got to tell you, it's not an easy one, but... As you can see, learn through our mistakes, and it'll be a little easier for you to place them on. Again, GV Crash Bars on the Rebel 1100 DCT. Thanks for watching.